Greetings, members one and all of the Salivation Nation. Gold and silver post a sharp decline heading into the weekend. Let's explore. Yes, that's right. The metals are taking a downward move. Pretty sharp declines in terms of dollar figures. And, sometimes I get a criticism whenever I make videos like this talking about, well, it's a sharp decline or they're plunging. But, you know, when you think of it in terms of dollars, especially if silver loses 75 cents in a day, that's a pretty big drop, even though it really accounts to less than 3% in this case. And for gold as well, almost $20 in a day, that's a pretty big drop. For dollar figures in just one day movement downwards. So these are fairly steep movements, though they're not catastrophic by any stretch, but that's just it. They won't be, they never will be for gold and silver, be catastrophic drops, because really, what are they? They are safe havens. They are here to protect us in times of economic strife. And even though the dollar has strengthened, and that's one of the primary reasons why, the prices aren't like plunging completely into the doldrums, into the basement, so to speak. Platinum took the biggest hit today with a $47 drop as of the recording of this video. Market Watch has a video talking about this, or has an article here, and we'll take a look at it. It's declines to post a loss for the week as U.S. dollar firms up. And a lot of this is coming after a proposal of the incoming president, Joe Biden, announcing a $1.9 trillion COVID-19 relief plan. And this is the U.S. dollar strengthening because of this. And this is kind of what's going to happen, typically what does happen, whenever there's something that is at least perceived to help the economy, but what's going to happen down the road is going to dilute the money supply, and that's going to be positive for gold and silver. It was a choppy week for gold and silver as conflicting themes pulled and tugged against the precious metal. Lukman Otunuga, senior research analyst at FXTM, told MarketWatch, while bearish investors were inspired by an appreciating dollar and rising bond yields, bulls derived strength from surging coronavirus cases and renewed lockdown restrictions. February gold was down negative 1.38%, gave up $21.50 or 1.2% to settle at $1,829.90. The settlement was the lowest for a most active contract since the 1st of December, according to FactSet data. Silver for March delivery shed 94 cents, or 3.6%, to end at $24.86 an ounce, following a 0.9% climb a day earlier. For the week, gold ended 0.3% lower, while silver logged a 0.9% weekly advance. In Friday dealings, the dollar traded up nearly 0.6% at 90.752 as gauged by the ICE U.S. Dollar Index, DXY, a measure of the buck against a half dozen major developed currencies. And all this time I thought it was six other currencies. The dollar for the week, meanwhile, was looking at a 0.7% gain with a 10-year Treasury note yield is at 1.091%, has held mostly steady at around 1.1% since last Friday. Richer yields and a stronger dollar can dull the appeal of owning a dollar-priced bullion. On Thursday, gold found some support, moving off the session lows, at the Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell said that it isn't time to consider exiting easy money policies as the U.S. combats the economic crisis wrought by the COVID-19 pandemic. Now it's not time to be talking about an exit, Powell said in a webcast with Princeton University on Thursday. With the Fed chair pledging to provide ample warning time before any such tapering so as to avoid a repeat of the infamous taper tantrum of 2013, gold bulls can take heart from the continued central bank support that they should limit the precious metals downside for a while longer, wrote Han Tan, market analyst at FXTM, in a research note on Friday. So I think we're not gonna see them go too much lower than they are now. In my view, we could see potentially gold go into the high 1700s, but I don't think it's gonna go in the mid 1700s like some people predict, or even lower. On Friday, Minneapolis Federal Reserve President Neil Kashkari said inflation could be rising, but there isn't much risk of it getting out of control. Over the long run, commodity analysts remain bullish on gold, particularly on the back of outsized U.S. government spending, which could devalue dollars and buttress gold prices. And these economic relief plan that Biden is proposing will circulate cash. It will bring the velocity of money to a higher level than it is now, and likely to fuel speculation around inflationary pressures rising in the U.S., Lukeman said. Gold, which is considered a hedge against inflation, may receive a tailwind from fiscal stimulus. Biden's fiscal plan calls for around the $1,400 per person direct payments to most households. By the way, I've never received my $600 yet, and I do qualify for it. A $400 a week unemployment insurance supplement through September, expanded paid leave, and increases in the child tax credit, and help for states with the COVID-19 vaccine rollout. On Friday, investors also digested the latest U.S. economic data. December retail sales fell for a third straight month, down 0.7%. Economists polled by Dow Jones and Wall Street Journal has forecast a 0.1% decline. So we'll see. All right, very good. So there's where the metals are. Platinum fell. Palladium fell. Rhodium held steady at 20,500. But there they are. The prices for the metals. Will refresh this page again to kind of see where we're at. But it is intriguing to see these movements take a downward trend. So if you're a buyer or thinking about buying, that's the beauty of this thing happening on a weekend. You can contemplate your purchases over the weekend because the prices are frozen. And you can find potentially some deals out there, and you got time to shop around as the market finishes it out on Friday. I always like these dips that happen on a weekend because that means it gives you some time to do that shopping. So there you have it. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Hope you enjoyed this video. Would like to extend a multitude of gratitude to you all for taking the time to watch, and encourage you to please rate and hit that bell for future notifications of videos as they come available. Share, comment, and after all of that, subscribe.